What a dump.
What's wrong with me, Doctor?
Pink lights, ballet girl, blue shorts, a lot of hoopla.
What happened, Karen? What happened with everybody?
I'll kill you!
Keep your filthy hands off me! Hush!
Welcome to, the 200th hour of tonight's all-night Joan Crawford binge. I'm Steve Ribello, co-author of Bad Movies We Love, the book and the monthly Movie Line magazine column.
And I'm Ed Margulies, one of Movie Line's executive editors. I'm also Steve's Bad Movies We Love co-conspirator. By the 1950s, Joan Crawford had been a movie star for almost 30 years. She was still plugging away in junk like Queen Bee, in which she plays a vicious schemer in that mow them all down style that makes her a bad movie immortal.
That's right. Now, until her adoptive daughter, Christina, dished the dirt in this shocking memoir, Mommy Dearest, who would have guessed that the monster like the one Crawford plays in Queen Bee was exactly like her real self? Some people might wonder whether we're actually watching Joan's home movies.
Aren't I wicked?
Yes, as a matter of fact, you are.
Not us, of course, but I'd have to say that other people thought so, because compare this magic Queen Bee moment to this one in the movie version of Mommy Dearest with Faye Dunaway playing Joan Crawford. Listen to how Betsy Palmer in Queen Bee talks all about Eva, the character that Joan plays.
She'll sting you one day. Ever so gently, so you hardly even feel it, till you fall dead.
Or until you fall dead laughing.
I'll make you sorry for this.
Back in your hive, honeybee.
She'll win Steve back over, just watch.
Any man's my man if I want it that way.
Dream on, Joan. Hey, now let's get a buzz watching the delightfully bad Joan Crawford sting him to death in Queen Bee.
Once, now I'm immune.
I'll make you sorry for this.
Will you?
You know I will.
And now, back to the bad boys of bad, Ed Margulies and Steve Ribello on TNT's Bad Movies We Love.
You know, one reason Joan Crawford's stardom lasted an astounding 5 decades was that she supposedly knew how to keep her fans interested by reinventing herself all the time.
Good. Right, Ed, in one movie she'd sing and dance, in the next she'd play a tramp or a virtuous wife in the next one. Why not Broad even ice skated in one movie?
Yeah, for all the good it did her. I mean, because Joan could hardly change her facial expression, she had to rely solely on dyeing her hair and, you know, changing her look.
Believing women all across America actually wanted to look like Joan and Queen Bee, Warner Brothers suggested that theater owners hook up with beauty parlors to give Mrs. America
the Joan Crawford makeover. Ta-da! Serious dementia here. But if some of you out there really do want to be Queen Bee for a day, here's all you're going to need. First, a black marker will give your brows and lashes the desired look of mating caterpillars.
For that bright red gash of a mouth. And those massive shoulders. Try these on for size.
Say, what about that sophisticated Crawford do? Well, voila. Tacky jewels in your hair. Lovely.
See? Nothing to it. That got us thinking. Which of today's celebrities could use a Joan Crawford redo?
Whoa. Some people are clearly beyond help. Oh, well. Let's watch Joan pour honey on all those trashy lines of dialogue.
And zing more of those trashy co-stars in Queen Bee.
And now back to Joan Crawford and Barry Sullivan in Queen Bee on TNT's Bad Movies We Love.
Naturally, I've been anxious, but, well, you've relieved my mind tremendously, Doctor.
Well, it's a difficult situation, but not entirely strange to a psychiatrist.
Celebrate 5 years of TNT. Coming up on Bad Movies We Love, Joan Crawford really cleans house as the compulsive Harriet Craig. Then Cliff Robertson cracks under the strain of his marriage to Joan, and who wouldn't, in Autumn Leaves. Join the month-long celebration as TNT turns 5.
Listen to this bull from the publicity department. Joan Crawford in Queen Bee combines the acting authority that won her an Academy Award for Mildred Pierce with the glamour of the true star.
That's good, that's good. How about this one? There's a great Hollywood tradition behind roles like Miss Crawford plays in Queen Bee. Vivian Leigh attracted similar attention as the Southern Belle of Gone with the Wind. I mean, what nerve!
You're making this one.
I'm not.
Wait,
here's another one. And Betty Davis achieved similar special fame with her work in Of Human Bondage.
Well, Joan Crawford certainly achieved special fame with bad movie fans like us. Here's my favorite ad. It says, Joan, so excitingly good when she's so wonderfully bad.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I probably couldn't have put it better myself. Maybe I could have.
Here's another gem. She destroys her rivals and no male around her can long survive.
Yeah, meaning no male co-star around her can long survive. But wait until you see what happens to game show panelist-to-be and starlet Betsy Palmer in an upcoming scene.
Oh, you know, there was something here about Betsy Palmer.
What?
Queen Bee's new kind of blonde says, why does a Hollywood blonde have to be dizzy, sexy, or avaricious?
Okay. As a new kind of Hollywood blonde, answer the question. Why? Oh, why?
You know, he couldn't get through one show without making some nasty crack about my naturally blonde hair.
And now, back to Joan Crawford and Barry Sullivan in Queen Bee on TNT's Bad Movies We Love.
Oh, I'm so bored I could scream.
Celebrate 5 years of TNT. Coming up on Bad Movies We Love, Joan Crawford really cleans house as the compulsive Harriet Craig. Then Cliff Robertson cracks under the strain of his marriage to Joan, and who wouldn't, in Autumn Leaves. Join the month-long celebration as TNT turns 5.